Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the quarterly return and monthly payment scheme in relation to the GST. Friends, the GST council in its 42nd meeting already recommended that there should be a quarterly return and monthly payment scheme for the purpose of a taxpayer having the aggregate turnover up to rupees 5 crore. So, the scheme is already notified in the recent past by the Government of India, and now from 1st January 2021, this scheme shall be available. So, the taxpayer having the aggregate turnover up to 5 crore in the preceding financial year can opt for this scheme. What are the features of this scheme? So, we have already discussed. The registered person whose aggregate turnover in the preceding financial year is up to 5 crore and who are right now filing the GSTR 3B monthly is eligible for this scheme. This scheme would be effective from 1st January 2021. Further, the GSTN system would itself calculate the aggregate turnover of the taxpayer based on the data available with it. Now, the second question may arise. How to opt for this scheme? So, the facility to opt for this scheme, that is the quarterly return monthly payment scheme, is available throughout the year. So, a registered person can opt for this scheme for any quarter from the first day of the second month of the preceding quarter. Same for example, if you want for a QRMP scheme, that is a quarterly return monthly payment scheme, for a July to September, then you can opt from the first day of the second month of the preceding quarter. So, what is the preceding quarter? April to June. It is the preceding quarter to July to September. So, first day of the second month. So, April to June. What is the second month? May. So, first day of the second month of the preceding quarter. So, he can opt for this option from first day of the May. Up till when he can opt for this scheme? To the last day of the first month of the quarter. So, first month of the quarter is July. What is the last day? 31st July. So, he can opt for this scheme for the purpose of July to September quarter from the 1st May to 31st July. However, the registered person is not required to exercise option every quarter. It means, once you have opted for this scheme, you can continue to be in this scheme up till when your turnover does not cross 5 crore during the year. So, the scheme is not required to be opted for each quarter separately. Once it is exercised, it shall be valid for a future tax period. Further, one most important thing is this QRMP scheme is GSTN wise, means a person having a one PAN, having a multiple GSTN, so he can opt for one GSTN as a QRMP scheme, and for the remaining GSTN, he cannot opt for QRMP scheme and he can go for a normal return. So, this scheme is on a GSTN wise. So, it is not compulsion said that all the GSTN having a same PAN must have to continue with this QRMP scheme. So, this is option for a GSTN number wise. The quarterly furnishing return detail of outward supply with the invoice furnishing facility. So, what is the current status? The person is required to furnish the GSTR 1 for the purpose of detail of outward supply on the quarterly basis or on the monthly basis depending on the case to case basis of the taxpayer. Now, the invoice furnishing facility shall be introduced. Further, this facility is optional. This facility is not a compulsion on the taxpayer. So, the supplier can upload invoice on a continuous basis. However, the taxpayer can upload maximum 50 lakh invoice in each of the 2 months of the quarter. So, the facility of invoice furnishing is optional. The details of invoice furnishing under this facility in the first 2 months are not required to furnish again in the GSTR 1. So, this is the facility only for the purpose of viewing the data इन जीएसटी आर टी टू बी फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर मंथ। हाउएवर दिस स्कीम इज रिगार्डिंग इनवॉइस फर्निशिंग फैसिलिटी इज नॉट कंपल्शन, इट इज द ऑप्शनल। फर्दर देर इज अ कैप दैट मैक्सिमम 50 लाख इनवॉइस कैन बी अपलोडेड इन ईच ऑफ द 2 मंथ ऑफ द क्वार्टर। सो इंस्टेड ऑफ जीएसटी आर वन द पर्सन हु आर ऑप्टिंग फॉर द क्वार्टरली रिटर्न मंथली फाइलिंग स्कीम देयर में बी इनवॉइस फर्निशिंग फैसिलिटी दो इट इज अ ऑप्शनल। दे सप्लायर कैन अपलोड इट्स इनवॉइस ऑन द पोर्टल। फर्दर वेन एवर दे आर फाइलिंग द जीएसटी आर वन रिटर्न सच इनवॉइस विच आर फर्निश थ्रू इनवॉइस फर्निशिंग फैसिलिटी नीड नॉट रिक्वायर टू बी फर्निश अगेन इन द फॉर्म नंबर जीएसटी आर वन। नाउ देर इज अ स्पेसिफिक प्रोविजन हाउ टू ऑप्ट फॉर दिस स्कीम फ्रॉम जानुअरी टू मार्च 2021। सो वेन द स्कीम इज कमेंस सो द जीएसटीएन सिस्टम वुड इटसेल्फ कैलकुलेट द टर्न ओवर ऑफ द टैक्स पेयर एंड बेस्ड ऑन द डेटा अवेलेबल विथ इट इट कैन आइडेंटिफाई द टर्न ओवर अप टू 5 करोड़ टैक्स पेयर। फर्दर द टैक्स पेयर हु हैव ऑलरेडी फर्निश्ड द अक्टूबर 2020 रिटर्न बाय 30th नवंबर सेल ऑटोमेटिकली माइग्रेटेड टू द न्यू सिस्टम ऑन द कॉमन पोर्टल। फर्दर द टैक्स पेयर हैविंग अ टर्न ओवर लेस देन 5 करोड़ बट दे आर फाइलिंग अ मंथली जीएसटी आर वन दे कैन नॉट ऑटोमेटिकली माइग्रेटेड टू दिस न्यू स्कीम। सो द टैक्स पेयर हैविंग अ टर्न ओवर अप टू रुपीज 1.5 करोड़ बट फाइलिंग जीएसटी आर वन मंथली बेसिस दे आर नॉट ऑटोमेटिकली माइग्रेटेड टू न्यू सिस्टम। सो इट इज एडवाइजेबल फॉर द ऑल द टैक्स पेयर दैट दे शैल फाइल द अक्टूबर 2020 रिटर्न बाय नवंबर 30th 2020। द टैक्स पेयर हु हैव नॉट फाइल द अक्टूबर 2020 ऑन और बिफोर 30th नवंबर 2020 विल नॉट बी माइग्रेटेड टू दिस स्कीम। दे विल एबल टू ऑप्ट फॉर दिस स्कीम वंस द जीएसटी आर 3B एज अ ड्यू ऑन द डेट ऑफ एक्सरसाइज द ऑप्शन हैज बीन फाइल। सो इट इज एडवाइजेबल दैट द टैक्स पेयर शुड फर्निश द अक्टूबर 2020 रिटर्न इन टाइम सो दैट देयर डेटा इज एलिजिबल फॉर माइग्रेशन टू द न्यू स्कीम। नाउ वॉट इज द मंथली पेमेंट ऑफ अ टैक्स स्कीम। सो Now the new due date, up till now the due date is 20, 22 and 22nd, 24th, depending on the state, A category state to B category state or your turnover exceeding 5 crore. So there may be a different date for the purpose of payment of tax. Now the new due date, that is the 25th day of the next month for the purpose of payment is notified for the purpose of taxpayer opting a QRMP scheme. So the registered person opting for a QRMP scheme will require to pay tax in the first 2 months for the quarter by depositing the amount in a GST PMT 06. So you have to pay the tax on a monthly basis via generic challan in a form number PMT 06. Further, what is the due date? 25th day of the next month. Whatever the amount you have deposited via this scheme can only be utilized for the purpose of set-topping your liability for the particular quarter with regard to GSTR 3B. Now, there may be a due system for the purpose of monthly payment of tax. Fixed sum method and a self-assessment method. Under the fixed sum method, you will get the prepaid challan from the system. That is, if you are filing the return on a quarterly basis, that 35% of your tax liability for a particular last quarter, you will get such amount in the pre-filled challan and you have to pay the tax. Further, no interest would be required to pay if there may be a difference in a liability while filing the GSTR 3B and there may be a difference while paying the tax. Further, there will be a no late fee on a delay in a payment of tax using the form PMT 06. So, there is a system of a fixed sum method. Under the fixed sum method, you will get pre-filled challan. under pre-fill challan there may be a two category. If you are filing the monthly return, you have filed the monthly return in the last month, then you will get the pre-fill challan with the amount what you have paid in the last month. If you have paid and filed it return on the basis of quarterly, then you will get the 35% of the liability of a previous quarter as a pre-fill challan in the GST challan. So further, if there is a difference between whatever you have paid and actual liability, there will be a no interest, because this is the fixed sum method. It is challan generated by system itself. Further, there will be a no late fee on a delay in payment of a tax in a form PMT 06. Now the next method is the self-assessment method. Under the self-assessment method, the person will calculate his outward liability. He will calculate its ITC based on its GSTR to be purchase invoice, GSTR 2A, etc. And he will determine his actual liability and he will pay the tax on a monthly basis. Here, the interest would be applicable if the liability will be different. So, what is the difference? Under the fixed sum method, interest is not applicable. Under the self-assessment method, interest is applicable. However, under the both the scheme, no late fee is required for the purpose of delay in a payment of tax. Under the quarterly return monthly payment scheme, the GSTR 3B is required to file quarterly by the due date, that is the 22nd day or a 24th date, depending on the class A state or a class B state. Further, after payment of a tax and after filing of a GSTR 3B, whatever the amount will remain in your cash ledger can be claimed as a refund, or you can use such payment balance in an electronic cash ledger for the purpose of adjustment in a next quarter. How to opt out for this scheme? The person whose aggregate turnover exceeds the 5 crore during the quarter, he can opt out for this scheme and he can opt for a monthly scheme from the succeeding quarter. Now, this may be an option for the purpose of a payment of a tax, and you have to pay the amount equivalent to the 35% of a tax liability paid for the last quarter if the return is furnished the quarterly, and if the return is furnished monthly, you can pay the tax liability which is paid in your last month. Further, this facility is on the basis of a GSTN wise. So, one GSTN may opt for this scheme, one other GST may not opt for this scheme, even though the PAN number is same. So, this is the discussion for the purpose of a scheme, quarterly return monthly payment scheme. Thank you.